Welcome back and many thanks for staying with us. Now, the drought situation in Kenya has affected not just the human population, but the livestock population as well, with up to 5% livestock mortality witnessed in the country. In our continuing series, Drought Diaries, I paint you the picture of the plight of livestock in the ongoing drought. Footsteps through the plains of Godoma Didiko lead you to a site that is becoming all too familiar in Marsabit County. A goat carcass here, and a few meters away, the remains of a camel. Even this beast of the desert couldn't survive the ravaging drought. Hassan Alio says his community is living through one of its harshest times. He's had to take desperate measures to keep his livestock alive, but it's not easy.
Yote walikuwa walienda kwa Nordistan. Huko pia walikuwa walikosa maji na maji tuna gari anapeleka huko. Kushota hapa Moyale na belekwa baka Nordistan. Na wale wako huko kwa hiyo Gombe na Gambia ako huko wote pia wanakufa na njaa na maji. Juzi iko gari amepeleka maji huko. Alikoma kwa barabara. Na hiyo watu tulipeleka na bigi tano hapa maji kabla kukufa hawa.
The Kenya Red Cross reports a livestock mortality rate of 5%. The rate of malnutrition among livestock has also risen to a level of 15%, which is considered critical. Christine Leparnet welcomes us into her homestead. The traditional neckpiece she adorns me with signifying a warm welcome. On better days, tea made with goat milk would be a more befitting welcome. But it's not a choice she has. The goats no longer produce milk.
We haven't seen rain since last year. The little water we find, we have to share with livestock. They are demasiated.
Drought stress is causing unusual patterns of livestock migration in many parts of the country. Up to 70% of animals in arid counties have migrated to neighboring countries. This is said to be unusual for this time of the year.
Because at one time, when you have two good season, the number of livestock multiplies by 3-4 times. The land size is the same. So the overgrazing, depletion of resources, including water, and therefore now any slight drought now clears all these livestock. And we start again. We want to now move from that culture into having livestock that we can manage, livestock that can fetch good prices, provide milk, provide meat, provide money for other needs. That's the area that we want to continue.
But the health of many livestock has declined. Their demand have either fallen low or livestock markets completely gone unoperational. In North Horr and Loyangalani areas of Marsabit County, water points have dried up and livestock have to walk more than 25 kilometers for water.
Tunataka bohol na salanga pia.
Various stakeholders have put various measures to try and mitigate the situation, such as the Pasture Enclosure Initiative by World Vision, which preserves areas of land from grazing in preparation for harsh times.
At this moment now, when livestock are migrating to northern Kenya, and some even going to border, to Ethiopia, and this place is able to accommodate a few livestock that are weak, and therefore sustaining the food security within this place.
We think the only way to add, to change the economic landscape of these people is to put money in the pocket of the herders, and that's by creating market. And how do we do it? We are now targeting external market.
For days, I have traversed the vast county of Marsabit assessing the drought situation here. I've spent nights with children going to bed hungry,
walked hours with women going in search of water. For a county that has been mapped on an alert and alarm basis, the pictures on the ground are screaming red. My name is Sharon Momanyi, reporting from Marsabit County. And indeed, the call has been to see sustainable solutions arrived at in these arid areas. Let's move on now. And residents of Nairobi's Tasia 1 estate have called on the Nairobi governor, Evans Kidero, to nullify the contract for the upgrade and repair of their access road. The residents claim that since the contract was issued last year, nothing productive has been done by the contractor. Broken sewer pipes are strewn across sections of the road, posing danger to young and playful kids. And it is a nightmare to motorists too. Ever since the contract was issued, the contractor has only managed to lay sharp stones on the road and abandoned it. But the county government of Nairobi says that the work on the site stopped due to the challenge of many broken sewer pipes.
Tia, hii barabara tulisikia ati mwanamuka mwanamuka fulani amepewa kazi. Huyo mwanamuka tumjui na tuliambiwa pia anafanya kuvizia ya governor. Sasa ilikuwa kirafiki, kirafiki, no. Nipa nikupe, I don't know how they were working out.
Tuko na shida na tunataka contractor aje haraka. Na imekuwa vigumu kwa sababu atuweza kupata yeye kuja kusuluhisha hii shida.
Watu vile wanaamua kuama kwa sababu barabara imeharibika, wanaamua kuama kwa sababu hii mazingira. Mazingira imekuwa mbaya kwa sababu vile mnaona mtu hawezi akapita na gari yake pale ama watoto hawezi wakapita hapo. Kwa sababu mtoto akipita pale tayari atakuwa mkono.
All right, we take another short break here, but don't go too far. We still have a lot lined up on this edition of KTN Weekend Prime. Don't go too far.